never destroy the world again by a flood. And what is man's promise to God? The Noah covenant is an unconditional covenant because it does not depend upon anything that Noah or his descendants had to do to fulfill the covenant. The promise is based solely on God's faithfulness. Now, we can imply that Noah and his descendants were to obey God's rules, but it's not stated in that section in the Bible. The symbol of the covenant? We all know it's the rainbow. So whenever we see a storm with the thunder and the lightning and the clouds clear up, and we've seen the rainbow, we think of God's covenant with man. In the human relationship that developed, it's the family. It's Noah and his wife, his sons, and their children. The relationship of marriage develops into the relationship of a family. So what does that all mean to us today in our own lives? In our own lives, and most of us here have children or have grown children probably, we love our children. We want nothing but the best for them. We intend to keep our promises to our children, or at least we try. We fail, but we try. If they are naughty, we discipline them because we love them, because we want to teach them what's right. We want them to grow to be good people who can make good decisions for themselves. Very simply, God is a dad who loves us. We are his children. He wants nothing but the best for us. He intends to keep his promises, and he keeps them a lot better than we do from time to time. When we disobey his rules, when we disobey his commandments, we are disciplined. We are disciplined because God loves us. He wants to help us learn to make good decisions for ourselves, to bring us back into harmony with him. God is a father who keeps his promises.
I will never forget you, my people. I have carved you on the palm of my hand. I will never forget you. I will not leave you orphaned. I will Does a mother forget her baby, or a woman the child within her womb? Yet even if these forget, yes, even if these forget, I will never forget my home. Having all sweetness,
Lord Jesus Christ, you gave us the Eucharist as the memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of the sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you won for us in the peace of the kingdom where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
just again, thanks for coming. And if anybody would like a surrender card, I'll give it to you. It's Father's Day.
Thank you, everyone, for coming out. What a beautiful turnout and what a beautiful celebration. If you saw me coming up front, it's because I realized that we were supposed to be recording this. And then we got half of Deacon Dale's wonderful talk. Let's give him a hand for his wonderful talk. That was outstanding. That was very, very good. I do want to make a little pastoral announcement. Sometimes in adoration, people, you know, obviously kneeling is an incredible posture of humility before the Lord, surrender to the Lord, opening your heart to the Lord. Some people, though, have had surgeries on both knees. Some people have sciatica. Some people have back problems. And there's a whole host of other things that might make it difficult for you. It's okay to kneel down for a while if you want. And if you can't at all, feel free to be seated, okay? If you're there and it's an endurance practice for you that you can barely, and you're so preoccupied with barely able being able to kneel like some people are, you know, just sit back and just let the Lord love you, okay? And so everybody just kind of, and if you want to kneel the whole time, that's okay too, but it's, you don't have to feel like I have to go to surgery next month because I'm doing this, okay? So again, thank you everyone, and you know, just kind of go through the book, read a little bit. At night, I read about a half hour every night of some kind of reading. And you'd be surprised how much reading you can get done if you commit like to a half hour every night. And the Lord will touch you in that study time as well. So again, thank you for coming, and let's continue to move from dust to glory. God bless.